Hello, welcome to Moo Moo Math, where we upload a new math video every day. In this video, I'd like to show how to find the surface area of a cube, a rectangular prism, a triangular prism, and a square pyramid. Let's get started.
The area of the cube is, the formula is 6 times the side squared. So, remember, a cube has each side is the same length, and the length is 10, so it will be 6 times 10 squared, which is equal to 6 times 100, which is equal to 600, and remember, the surface area is squared, so it will be meters squared. Okay, the cube is pretty simple. Again, the formula is 6 times the side squared. Now, with this rectangular prism, as you know, once you know the formula, you just plug in some of your numbers. The formula is going to be 2 times the length times the width, and then 2 times the length times the height, and 2 times the width times the height. So, let's go ahead and identify each of these. The 7 will be the length, the 3 will be the width, and the 4 will be the height. So now we just plug in numbers. So for the length, we have 7 times the width, which is 3 times 2, and then we have 7 times the height, and this will be our height, which is 4 times 2, and then we have the width times the height, which is 3 times 4 times 2. And so then if we do this, this will equal to 42. 7 times 3 is 21 times 2 is 42. This is equal to 56. 7 times 4 is 28. 28 times 2 is 56. And this will be 3 times 4 is 12 times 2 is 24. And when you add all this up, it equals to 122, and the unit of measure is feet squared. Okay, let's go ahead and look at this triangular prism. And triangular prisms and square prisms are a little tricky because they use slightly different formulas. Formula for the triangular prism is going to be the perimeter of the base, and I've shaded it in to help you make see it a little bit easier, times the height of the prism, and that will give you the lateral area. And then you add that to the area of the two bases of the triangle. And so, and then it would be 2 times 1 half base times the height. And then you add these two together. So let's first look at the perimeter. The perimeter of the triangular base is 3 plus 4 plus 5. This leg right here is 5, so that will be 3 plus 4 plus 5 times the height of the prism in this case. And if you'll notice that the way it is sitting, the height will be right here. So that will be times 5. And if you multiply all this together, this is equals to 12 times 5, which is equal to 60. So now we have the lateral area. Now we have to calculate the area of the two triangular bases. And if you redraw this, the base actually looks like this. And then this particular side is 4, this will be 3, and the hypotenuse will be 5. So that makes it a little bit easier. So you're going to go 1 half times the base, which is 3, times the height, and you can see the height because it's perpendicular, times 4 equals 3 times 4 is 12, half of that is 6, and remember you have two bases, 1, 2, so that will equal 6 times 2 is 12, and so I add those two together, so it will be 60 plus 12 is 72, and it is centimeters square. And look at the area of this square pyramid. And the formula we're going to use for it, again, we're going to calculate the lateral area, and we're going to add that to the base area. And for the lateral area of a square pyramid, we will take 1/2 the perimeter times the slant height or slant length, okay? And then for the base area, since this is a square base, we're just going to take the side squared, okay? So let's get started. Let's first look at the perimeter, and what we can use for the perimeter, if we look, the perimeter will be 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4, which we can write as 4 times 4. And then the slant length, or if you'd like to think of it as the slant height, is given, and it is 6, so it'll be times 6. And so 4 times 4 is 16. And if we take 1/2 of 16, because remember it's 1/2 times the perimeter, 1/2 times 16 is equal to 8, and 8 times 6 is 48. So that gives us our lateral area. So I'm going to title that lateral area. So now we need to calculate the base area, and that is just side squared because it is a square. So we have a side of 4, so that will be 4 squared, which will be 4 times 4 is equal to 16. And that is our base area. So now we will take 48 plus 16, and that gives us a grand total of 64, and it is in inches squared because surface area is always squared. Hope this helps. Moo Moo Math uploads a new math video every day.